Dang it. I'm gonna try to find these songs in the game, because I'm getting a lot of copyright my videos. Like this song right now that's playing. That's not mine. Where's my room? Is this my room? Max's room. All right.
Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon.
Yep. Right. What do we do here? Alright, we need to get the flash drive. Happy birthday, Maxine. We can't believe it's been 18 whole years since you were brought to us. Max, your principal sent me an email saying that you told some tall tales about a Blackwell honor student. Is this true? Principal said that this was a serious false charge and that he's worried you're telling stories. Call me ASAP so he can talk about this. Mom.
Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
Damn it. Let's see what's in here. Nothing. Nope. Nope. Damn it. Damn it.
Looks like Dana left me a little quick. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room. Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Juliet, what the hell?
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool. You are ridiculous.
She's your friend.
Friends don't sex with their best friend's boyfriend.
No, probably not. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk, just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Watson?
Juliet Watson.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care.
Yeah.
So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria?
She saw the sex. And Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Oh my god. Alright, let's go into Victoria's room. Juliet. Victoria's room.
Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here. And this one there. A pattern is emerging.
Alright, let's not do that just yet. Camera, let's see where's like her phone.
Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much? How insecure. Victoria is a real Jefferson Broopy.
So, right.
Dior, Givenchy, you could pay for my tuition with that wardrobe. That is a tasty plasma. Maybe I could sneak in and watch Final Fantasy Spirits Within.
Alright, let's use the laptop.
That's nice, Victoria. And who the hell thinks I'm a hipster? Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Alright, how do you do that? Alright, let's print email. Great, where's... What the hell is a printer? Oh. Take.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Alright, let's get the hell out of here.
Juliet, read this.
Course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dina.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zach?
No. But I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
We're the Blackwell Ninja.
He's free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Who the hell's Warren?
Almost done. Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren. That looks like a home pregnancy test.
Well, Max, that's mine. Thank you.
You shouldn't.
You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Let's rewind time.
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her.
And stop. Great. Let's just get this flash drive and go on.
Must protect my precious, so Max never has to choose.
Alright. Let's get out of here. Alright, let's talk to, Alyssa again.
Fuck this shit!
Damn, I better rewind.
Let me see that again.
Alyssa, move your head!
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
This action will have consequences. Damn.
Now that's what I call instant karma.
Yeah. Alright, let's get the hell out of here and deliver our USB drive to Warren. Go to parking lot? Of course.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Intervene.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Mac, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me.
I don't care. I'm not gonna rewind that. Again, I don't own this song. I'm not trying to get another copyright on my videos.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Juliet.
How could that?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Mac. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
I won't bother you then. I have to go see Warren before he melts. See you.
Yeah, sure, we'll all be partying later back in Victoria and the Vortex Club.
Yeah. Sure.
See you around, Mac.
Alright, let's meet up with Warren.
Come on,
hey,
over here.
Warren.
Please. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh, 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Man, I saw that Victoria didn't take down that pic of you on Facebook. Major bitch move.
No worries, Warren. I took a sweet shot of Victoria I can't wait to share.
Oh, score one for Team Max.
It'll be so Team Max.
To see her ass yeah. Face all over the interwebs.
I guess she does deserve it for all the shitty things she's done to people here.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Let's lie.
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Not at all. Sensitive is good. Unless you're a pushover. You have hip taste and a quick mind.
Thanks for noticing, Max.
The right girl.
You're welcome.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I don't want to speak about it. This is kind of a crazy day for me. I mean, I literally think I'm going crazy.
I may be a pest, but I'm a good listener.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
Oh, no.
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal? Now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Carver.
Leave me alone.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Oh.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Oh! Oh, damn!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
I have no idea. I know he's a Prescott.
An asshole. Your friend really stood up for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah. Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Martin Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Oh man, are
not
you serial?
Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Welcome home, Max.
Be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Home, shit, home. The hell?
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step here will make sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Sure.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Not much. You know me. I like to observe the world more than participate.
I can't say I know you anymore. Maybe you love to go clubbing every night.
Can you see me at a rave?
I'd dose those candy-flipping morons and watch them twitch into a DJ dance death rattle. Take a photo of that. So tell me.
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless. I know my room is a disaster, but you can find a disc.
Alright, just look up. How the hell can you even find a disc in here? Trash can.
Who does think Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets?
She doesn't. Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
Putting it mildly.
So, who is she? Do you mind talking about her?
Rachel Amber. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia, without a word, without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than...
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody
Dang,
in my life.
Dude.
My dad,
that's sad.
Rachel, gone. Can you put on some music now?
Alright, we're gonna put in some music.
It won't play without any power.
Won't play without. Right. Let's put the CD in.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment. Can you let me chillax for a bit? Alone? The tools are still downstairs.
Okay, chill.
Nope. Someone locked it from the other side. Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school. Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me. One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Yes! Score! Ooh, precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. That does not look stable. Let's see. The tools are stuck, out of reach, and no way in hell to get them. Man, I should have done that before they fell.
True.